Let's now talk to Murimi Mwangi, who has been following this for us today. Murimi, good afternoon to you. So these are not the only leaders appearing before the disciplinary committee today. We have the likes of Governor Joho, Okoth Obado as well over the Migori chaos and others. What have you been able to find out so far about those that have appeared before the committee?
Well, good afternoon, Sophia. Those are among the few of the 16 leaders that will be appearing before the ODM disciplinary committee to answer to previously reported instances of chaos in ODM campaigns, of course, largely last week ahead of what it was initially to be the date for the ODM party primaries. In the morning hours, nominated Senator Elizabeth Ongoro appeared before the team, as well as Ruaraka MP TJ Kajwang. He left that particular meeting a few minutes ago. And of course, other key leaders are expected here, including Migori Governor Okoth Obado, as well as Mombasa Governor Ali Hassan Joho, as you mentioned, but also expected to appear before that particular team in the afternoon is Busia Governor Sospeter Ojamong, who will be followed hours later by Funyula MP Paul Otuoma, both of who have been accused of being behind recent chaos in Busia County that left one person dead. And before he walks into that particular committee, I am here with the Busia governor, and it will be important to get some answers from him. Bora Governor, you have been accused of being one of the two leaders that were behind the chaos that were reported in Funyula. How true is that, and what exactly happened, and what will you be telling the committee as you appear before them this afternoon?
I think I've just been called to explain myself on what happened the previous week, where we witnessed incidents of violence in the county. Indeed, most of the incidents involved an attack to my supporters at the convoy, and I've brought the evidence with me, and the matters were reported to the police. So I'm just going to confirm that my supporters were attacked in various places, and the matters reported to the police. So I wasn't the aggressor, but I think I was a victim of those hooligans.
Well, you have been accused of storming into a rally that had been held by your opponent, the Funyula MP, and that's what has been alleged to have been the cause of the chaos that left one person dead. You're saying that's untrue?
That's not true. That day I was in another sub-county campaigning, right? But that was a clash between an MCA and a member of parliament for Funyula. They come from the same area. That day I was very far away from that area when that incident occurred. So I should not be blamed for that. But it's the MCA who was having his meeting there, and the MP stormed it, and that several people were injured.
You said you've brought some evidence here. What sort of evidence is that? And is it likely to implicate somebody for that violence other than you?
Yes, I've brought quite a number of pictures, videos showing how people were attacking, breaking people's vehicles, people's houses, stoning people in rallies, injuring them. I've also brought records of people who have gone to hospital, been attended to, and the OB numbers in police stations where these incidents were reported.
Well, the family of that particular victim who died in those chaos has demanded for compensation. I will be putting this question also to your opponent. Have you made any attempt to seek out that family and see what assistance you can give them? Because they argue that their death was as a result of a contest of which you are one of the parties contesting.
Anyway, if the death occurred, because I've not confirmed, I've just been hearing also that a death is regrettable. Definitely we shall try our best to chip in and assist the family, and might be if you had a family himself, the children, in the best way we can. Might be using the county programs and our own from our own pockets, just to support the children.
Perhaps my very final question, Bwana Governor. Tensions have been rising as a result of campaigns for the party primaries. I will be putting the same question to your opponent. What efforts have you as a candidate put in place to ease the tensions? Because the IEBC has said that the process has to be free and fair, free of any chaos.
Personally, Busia County has been a very peaceful county in all elections. But my opponent seems to have specialized in chaos, even at the constituency level. There is no election he has won without killing somebody. And even now, there's a case which has been stood over generally in court, awaiting him for murder. Murdering, killing a teacher, he's killed a teacher.
We can't discuss that because he's not here to defend himself regarding those allegations that you're raising against him.
Yes, but he knows. The matter was stood over generally. And the police were looking for him in the previous campaign, he never campaigned. So those are facts I'm stating. The case has not been concluded. And he has been vowing that he wants to engage in violence. Because one thing, he has never registered ODM people.
My question, Brother Governor, was efforts that you have put in place to ease the tensions against the chaos that have been ongoing in Busia.
Yes, we find that all candidates are peaceful. And we have campaigned for peaceful elections together with the church. But we launched it in our churches, with the Catholic Church and the Muslims. We've agreed, the youths in the county have met them, all of them. And we've agreed that let us have peaceful campaigns. These programs, we have them at a grassroots level. But these things are being imported from Nairobi to Busia by the members of parliament who think they might lose in the elections. They say that if you are confident of yourself, why don't you just participate? Why do you hire goons? You could find my opponent has hired over 1,000 people. He wants to unleash on people. Me, I just walk with two bodyguards. One body is enough. Why does he have to have all that security?
Thank you so much for your time, Mheshimiwa. We will be waiting to hear what the committee will have to say when you present the evidence that you say you have. That has been Busia Governor Sospeter Ojamong, one of the 16 leaders that will be appearing before the ODM Disciplinary Committee. We will be keenly following what transpires here today. Remember, a key spotlight on the ODM party will be with regard to how they handle the Migori chaos, for which key leaders have been summoned here today before the committee. Back to you, Sophia, in studio.